هيا على الفلاح.
People are going to be taken to paradise or towards hellfire. It's a famous passage. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا. Then Allah says, those who disbelieve, اللَّهُمَّ لَا تَجْعَلَ مِنْهُمْ, they are going to be herded. سِيقَ, سَاقَ يَعْنِي, سُسِيقَ يَعْنِي أُخِذَ. They were taken and they were moved quickly. They were herded. When you move somebody quickly along, then that's called سَاقَ يَسُوقُ. Nowadays in modern Arabic it's used even for driving a car. But back in the day, يَسُوقُ جَمَلًا عَلَى سَبِيلِ الْمِثَالِ. They say when you're herding a camel and you're making the camel run, not just walk, run, then this is siyaq. Okay, or so even. So Allah says the people of disbelief are not just going to be slowly walked towards Jahannam. They are going to be rushed towards Jahannam. Nobody wants to go towards Jahannam. People don't, their feet don't want to move. They want to stay back. Can you imagine a guy being dragged literally? But that dragging, you usually think, is very slow. Come on, get over here, get over here. And he's pulling back and you're dragging him. But no, these angels are very strong. They're just going to be dragged very, very quickly. When they get there, then the doors are open. They're not open before them. Not until the kafir reaches the gate. Then Allah opens the gate to Jahannam. And you know, this Jahannam, I made a parallel between Jahannam and prison. In prison. It's a really bad idea to leave prison gates open. It's a really bad idea. You only see prison gates open when a criminal's about to be taken in or somebody's about to be taken out. That's it. And it's open for those few seconds and it closes again. It locks up again. And that's the image of the people of hellfire. That's how they're going to be treated. This khutbah is not about hellfire, by the way. But I just want to make a comparison. If this khutbah was about hellfire, I would share with you that the people that are being dragged towards the hellfire, even before they get there, even though they're being taken very, very quickly, you know, when he sees it outside, he sees it, sees hellfire from a distance, he says, فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُوا ثُبُورًا وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا. He calls from a distance, just please kill me now. ثُبُورًا, immediate death, please. Execution, please. No prison time. Just kill me now, kill me now, kill me now. Then he will be taken. Then thrown inside. He's wishing for death already. From who? From the same guardian angels that are pushing him. That are taking him towards the gate. Allahumma la taj'alna min ashabin nar. As they are taken inside. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا. And the guardians, the vault keepers of Jahannam, are now talking to these prisoners as they're walking in. And they say to them, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ألم يأتيكم رسل منكم. No messengers among you came to you? You didn't get any messengers? Well, we're shocked. We thought these gates should remain closed. Who would be stupid enough to end up in Jahannam? There were so many messengers sent. You didn't get any? ألم يأتيكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم. That were reading on to you the miraculous revelations, the miraculous signs of your master. Quran was being read on to you, wasn't it? You weren't among the people, Torah was being read on to you. You were in the time of Musa alayhi salam. You were in the time of Zakariya alayhi salam. You were in the time of Isa alayhi salam. You didn't get messages? Why are you here? What would have to be wrong with you? Why weren't you using your intellect? And that is the exact words we're going to find in Surah Al-Mulk. لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ. That's the response to this. They're going to say, if we were only listening. If we only listened. Young brothers, sometimes you sit in a khutbah, and the khutbah is with an accent, or the khutbah is quoting a hadith or an ayah, and you're like, oh God, I've already heard this before. Oh God. And you start playing with your phone. I don't want to hear this, man. I heard this already. And a day will come, a person will be dragged into the hellfire, he's going to say, if only I listen. If only I listen. We don't come to the khutbah to be entertained, folks. We don't come here to be entertained. We come here to listen. That's what this is for. وَيُنْذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Weren't they constantly reminding you of the meeting of this day? Wasn't that the case with you? And what did they say? قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. They said, yeah, actually, quite right. That is the case, of course. No doubt about it. We heard that a lot. Oh my God, the talk about the Akhirah? The talk about the Day of Judgment? I heard that all the time. And I got so used to it that it doesn't even do anything for me anymore. I was like, man, when are they going to change the subject? When are they going to talk about something else? That's why the mudari' is used. Yundirunakum, not antarukum. They're consistently warning you about the meaning of this day. And you know what? I don't mind the khutbah being over and over and over again about the akhirah. I don't mind it. You know why? Because we don't have enough reminder of the akhirah in our lives. We really don't. We're immersed in dunya way too much. And second of all, the Qur'an makes it a priority. If you're reading the Qur'an from one end to the other, the thing that will come up the most is the akhirah. It just doesn't let you go. There's no page that lets it go. There's not a time, a moment in the Qur'an that Allah lets you forget about the akhirah. So how can we be like, I already know this, thank you. I already know day of judgment, heaven, hell, I got it. Can we move on to something else now? Like you're already ready for it. You and I are not ready. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those that are ready. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the previous surah of people of Jahannam, muqtaham, muqtaham. What that means is they are piled on top of each other. People of Jahannam are piled on top of each other. And he doesn't explain there what that means. Why? How are they piled on top of each other? What is that? What in the world does that mean? Why are they making a mountain of people? All he tells us there is, there's already a group of people, they're already crammed, there's no space left for them, and a new batch of people is being thrown in, and they, when he looks at them, when the people are already inside, look at them, they say, لَا مَرْحَبًا بِهِمْ. There's no space for them, they're not welcome here. كَمَا نَقُولْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ مَرْحَبًا لَا مَرْحَبًا بِهِمْ. They're not welcome here. Like, we got no space, we already got problems enough. Tell them to go back. And the guys from above say, no, لَا مَرْحَبًا بِكُمْ. You people, you're not welcome. You're the reason we got here. They're blaming each other. The newcomers into Jahannam are blaming the people that are already in Jahannam. Why is that happening? In this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla gives us a hint. He says, Mathwa. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبِئْسَ مَثْوَى الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. Mathwa is a place where you live and the previous generation before you lived and the previous generation before you lived. Like if you're living in a house where your father, your grandfather, your great-grandfather, his great-grandfather lived, then that place is your mathwa. And in Jahannam, it will form a kind of mathwa where the people of Kufr, who passed it down to their kids, who passed it down to their kids, who passed it down to their kids, are being piled one on top of the other, the next generation, the next generation, the next generation. Of all the people, Allah didn't call them disbelievers now, He calls them the people of arrogance and mutakabbirin. These are people that are full of themselves. These people had it all figured out. They don't need anybody's advice. They don't need any guidance. You know, at the very beginnings of our deen, you have to be humble enough to take advice. Because we take advice from Allah. We take advice from His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we're willing to say to ourselves, I don't know better. They know better. Allah and His Messenger know better. So whatever they say, I'm going to take it. Loads of angels that are actually holding the gates of Jannah open. Their only job is to hold the gates of Jannah open so one day you and I can walk through. What a mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah mentions no such thing for Jahannam, by the way. He mentions no such thing for Jahannam. He only mentions it for Jannah. You know, when you throw a party and you invite people to your house, obviously you live in London, so you have to be careful when you invite people to your house. I'm sure you don't leave the door open. But imagine that you live, you know, in a situation, you're inviting somebody and you're really waiting for them to come. Somebody important you invited, somebody you really love and you miss is coming. And you can't wait for them to come. You know what you do? Not only do you leave the door open, you stand by the door for them to come. And then those who had taqwa of their master are going to be rushed quickly to Jannah. Now why are they being rushed quickly? They already want to move quickly. But maybe their ability to run and move isn't good enough. So the angels expedite them on the express track and take them even faster. You and I know the scenes of judgment, they are horrifying. And believers can't wait to get into Jannah. They can't wait to get there. And it's a long walk. Allah Azza wa Jalla will describe in different surahs of Quran, you know, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Light will come out of their chest. Light will come out of their right hand. May Allah make us from them. And that light will allow them to walk towards Jannah. But you're walking slowly. Allah says, no, I'll give you a legion of angels that will aid you and rush you quickly through this mess. So as you're asking Allah, رَبَّنَا أَتْمِمْ لَنَا نُورَنَا, Allah, complete our light. On top of that, Allah is rushing you through the horror, through the difficult time, so you can get to the gates quickly. So now that you get to the gates, remember when the people of Jahannam were taken to the gates, then the gate were open? But Allah Azza wa Jalla says miraculously, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا لَمْ يَقُلْ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا قَالْ وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَأُحَلِيَا نَقُولْ هُنَا. While the gates were already open. Until they got to it, while the gates were already open. He doesn't say until they got to it, then the gates were open. The gates were already open. The gates were already in that state, so they can rush through quickly. So they don't have to wait outside, because waiting outside is to still be in the hashr, in the gathering, in the place where there's turmoil. You're not in safety yet. They're taken quickly inside into Jannah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make all of us from them that are taken quickly inside His paradise. How good you people are. Wow, looking good. This is good stuff. They're complimenting you. There's some nice people coming through. Angels are giving you compliments as you're walking in. فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. And enter it to stay forever. Because, you know, or you know, and if you're in an expensive hotel or a resort or something, how long is it going to last? So the angels are assuring you, listen, I know this is nice, but it's yours. Stay here forever. Don't think it's not for you. Don't think it's too above your class. No, this is you. This is all you. You people deserve. You're good people. And as we enter in, now they say, قَالُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Then they'll say, Alhamdulillah. Now you and I say Alhamdulillah all the time, don't we? But that Alhamdulillah is different. It's different. We say Alhamdulillah, you know, you come out of the house and it's not freezing weather. You're like, oh, Alhamdulillah, good day. You know, you're looking for your keys, you're getting late to work and you find it under your pillow. Alhamdulillah, okay. But when you walk into Jannah and you look around and then you just can't even help yourself and the words come out, Alhamdulillah, it's going to be different. It's going to be different. These words are very powerful. By putting Alhamdulillah here, you know what Allah has done? Every time you say Alhamdulillah for now, if you can remember, remind yourself of the Alhamdulillah you will say when you walk into Jannah. Just remind yourself of that. This Alhamdulillah is not cheap, it's a gift from Jannah. These are words that you will be saying and I will be saying in Jannah. And He let us inherit the earth. What beautiful language, Wallahi. He let us inherit the earth. He gave us the earth in inheritance, the earth of Jannah, in inheritance. What in the world does that mean? We already learned before, Husna Ma'ab, a wonderful place to go back to. Who are we inheriting it from? Our Father who was created for Jannah. إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا خُلِقَتْ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ خُلِقْتُمْ لِلْآخِرَةِ. The dunya was created for you, but you were created for the Akhirah. So finally we get to inherit the land that we were supposed to have, the earth we were supposed to have. But there are so many of us going into Jannah, and it's so huge. Where's my address? I'm trying to find my house. Because you know you pass by a lot of mansions, a lot of gardens. Which one's mine? You don't want to enter into somebody else's. These people of Jannah say, نَتَبَوَّأُ فِيهَا نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. We get to move into Jannah wherever we want. Tabawwa' means to move wherever, finding the right place. Yeah, there's good schools in this area, the neighborhood is nice, the real estate price is good, the neighbors are decent. Let me check everything before I pick my house. You'll get to pick.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.